I started working on 2009 with the intention of staying for 6 months to a year at most. And at the first day in the office, he showed me a model that I have developed during my PhD, and he modified and he told me that's an MR product. And suddenly I realized you can take a concept from like a simple equation on the paper and see it deployed on an MRI machine in a hospital. And I thought that must be really rewarding, and imagine how many lives could you touch this way. I have worked on a wide variety of topics and wide variety of imaging modalities for segmenting anomalies, particularly for oncology applications, so the detection and quantification of malignancy. However, the one exciting topic that I would like to highlight today is analyzing blood cells or blood cell differential from digital holographic microscopy. In this technology, we have used AI in every step in the way. So starting from the acquisition phase, we use machine learning techniques to optimize the acquisition parameters for the best image quality. So you get crisp images with the cells in focus, which would make the whole pipeline much more efficient. And for analyzing the red blood cells, we use deep learning technology to detect the red blood cells and to segment the boundaries of them for accurate volume computation. Then we present red blood cell volume distribution for the clinician because it's clinically important. I'm currently working on segmentation of cardiac structures in intracardiac echocardiography, ICE images, and the technology will be used in interventional procedures for treating atrial fibrillation. So during the procedure, the ICE catheter is used to acquire scattered 2D slices of the heart. And using deep learning, we leverage those sparse 2D information to provide a complete 3D reconstruction of the left atrium and the pulmonary veins. We also provide delineation of the boundaries of these structures, and that delineation will serve as a guide for the cardiologist to ablate in the correct spots and to avoid damaging any delicate tissue like the esophagus, for example. I think AI will have a great impact on the future of cardiology. On the short term, we are moving towards like more efficient, precise, and personalized treatment and diagnosis for cardiac diseases, mainly based on the wealth of information that we have. So when you go to the doctor, the precision of your diagnosis depends on the expertise of the doctor, and his or her expertise depends on the amount of cases that they have seen in their lifetime. Imagine that you have an AI-powered system that is trained with thousands or millions of data that is acquired from clinical centers from all around the world. This is what we do here. Our data lake has more than 1 billion images that are used in training our algorithms.